pretty neat. Everything in this game, the series, is kind of turned up to the extreme compared to the original.
Extreme!
So, I'm going back here, because as I said, this is 100% playthrough. So I'm going to run through the stage as fast as possible and get the one item that I missed. Because I couldn't obtain this item until I got the fire ability that you see me spamming. I definitely needed to get it to progress. So, here we go. And everything's pretty much the same as it was. Except now I'm using dash like a boss to get through as fast as possible. So I don't give a fuck. Which, by the way, of all the many reasons to start with this stage, because it's really easy, and Chill Penguin is a pretty easy boss, you get the dash attack, which is the best ability. Like, it's mandatory. This is the only Mega Man X game that you're going to start with, that you're going to begin the game and not have it. And it's not like this game is really hard where you really need it. And there's a hidden health tank. I'm getting the fuck out of here. I mean, you can get through most of this game just fine without the dash, but I really wouldn't want to. Because, as you can see, by the time I got the dash ability, I'm gonna spend probably 80% of the game using the dash. Whether it be to get across things faster, or to do a dash jump and get higher range, all these things. Now, here's another thing. Coming to this stage, because, why am I coming to this stage? I'm trying to remember. I mean, it's not particularly hard, but I don't have the Boomerkwanger's weakness, so it's a little bit harder than it should be. But it doesn't matter, I guess. I wanted to get this guy's ability, because his weakness is the ability that you obtain from Launch Octopus, right? And I want to obtain this guy's ability before I fight Launch Octopus, because Launch Octopus can be, you hit him with boomerangs and his arms fall off, which not only speeds up the battle considerably, but it eliminates like 2/3 of his entire attack arsenal. He's not reduced to complete impotence, but he's pretty close. So when I get to him, he'll be way easier to fight. And it's not like this guy is really hard to begin with. I mean, I'm gonna fight him pretty much the same way that you would if you had his weakness. That was dumb of me. Just took that blast right in the fucking shoulder blade. Ah, oh, come on. There. Happy. Kill this guy. There we go. Trying to get up these fucking walls. Now this part kind of pisses me off. Is look up there. You can see the health container floating around. You can't get it. You have to use the boomerang that you get from this guy to get it. And this is pretty much the very end of the stage. So they make you beat this guy and then come back with this guy's weapon so that you can get that fucking item. Kind of bullshit, in my opinion, but it's still way better than Mega Man X 2, which has fucking ridiculous placed items that you either get them or you instantly die and have to come back and try again. Or Mega Man X 3, which is way worse, way harder. You have to do that in such a particular way, and it's so fucking hard. But you'll see that when I get to it. So this guy just likes to kind of just wave dash around the area, disappearing like an idiot. But you don't want to stay on the ground, because, I mean, there's boomerangs, and he's trying to give you a big hug. But if he gives you a hug with his face, then you're pretty much dead, because he'll do like a ton of damage by flinging your ass helplessly into the ceiling with his face. It's not a happy thing to happen. Now, I don't know what the fuck a Kowanger is supposed to be, but apparently he is one. I think maybe it's some kind of roach or something, or a bug, because he kind of looks like a bug. and he acts like a bug. He's kind of got those antennas on his face. I don't know. He's kind of cool, though. Kind of weird. Kind of annoying because he never fucking stays still. I'd say enemies that phase in and out of reality. It seems so cheap. And so, like I explained, I'm gonna go right back to this fucking level to get every fucking item. And all I need to do is get the fucking boomerangs to get them. So, I treat you to an encore of this fucking bullshit level. Which, the thing is, you remember in, like, some of the old Mega Man, some of the first Mega Mans, Mega Man 1, Mega Man 2, they tried to, you know, they had a variety of different, things they wanted to try with the level design, right? And one thing they could never quite get right was vertical challenges. Like, most of Crash Man's stage was you climbing up, right? Some places it worked, some places it really didn't work. It was really bullshit. As you can see, I'm demonstrating this cool-ass move. It's pretty cool. If you, the boomerangs, they come around, they loop around, they come back to you. If you grab them, then you didn't spend the ammunition. You get the ammunition back. So you only get the ammunition expended for ones that get absorbed by hitting people. So it's pretty cool. Also, they can collect items. As you probably surmised from the fact that I told you that I needed them to get that health tank, and you're like, well, how are you going to get the health tank with just a boomerang? I don't understand how it makes sense. Because it grabs items. And it's cool. And it's only applicable for, like, two spots in this game. One of them is this heart thing, and one of them is something much later. And even then, it's just the fucking health thing. It's not important, but you can use it. Demonstrating how you can get the boomerangs stuck in an infinite loop around your body, which I like, is always pretty cool. Yay! Now I can get the fuck out of here. Peace out, fucker. So now, I'm gonna use this ability. Well, I'm not gonna use it on this guy, but... Actually, yes, I am. Okay, I remember, I forgot. I needed the boomerangs so that I can collect the hidden item here. So as you can see a bunch of debris from the plane that fell on this factory. What am I doing? Idiot. Wasted. No. Having button malfunctions is what's happening. I'm in the wrong button because I'm an idiot. There we go. Subtank number 3, I think it is. Should be number 3. One more. I'm using this hurricane attack because as I'm demonstrating and as I've pointed out, it's the most fucking awesome ability. Pretty much all the abilities in this game are pretty awesome. But, well, no, they're not. Some of them are pretty fucking worthless. Because they're just inferior to the other ones. Like, this is cool because I'm not positive. But I think that the Fire Blast is the fastest damage per second that you can get in any of the weapons. Because, like, I know that, like, the Hurricane does a fuck ton of damage. But that's all up front and it only gets you one, maybe two hits on an enemy. But I think the Fire Blast does way more damage per second. I don't think it's working so well in this guy. I don't know exactly what kills the guy. But one of the things I mentioned that, you know, benefits to destroying Storm Eagle first was that, you know, he's supposed to be able to shoot lightning all over the place. He's supposed to be way harder than that. But because I dropped a plane on the fucking factory, he doesn't, you know, all the lights keep going out and he doesn't have access to, all the electricity that he usually had. All those generators are broken. So he's mostly impotent. You only really have to worry about him running into you. Which isn't so bad, especially if you have the dash attack. And you just dash your way out of the little bubbles. Now this is a fucking annoying ass little jump. But you never have to make anything remotely like it again. You do have to make something like it in Mega Man X 3. I don't think you have to do it much in X 2. But in X 3, you have to do jumps like that. But, you may remember, or you may know, in X3, you get an air dash. which is totally awesome. And not just an air dash, but you get, you know, a vertical dash. So you could jump up. God damn it, these boomerangs are fucking stupid. Alright. You get a vertical air dash, where you just jump up, and then you can jump up again. So it's like a double jump. But then, you can unlock a double air dash. So you can basically triple jump. Which you don't really need for most of the game, but it comes in handy a lot when you're fighting Sigma. If only for that one little part. But you'll see what I'm talking about in a week or so when I put that fucking video up, I guess. So, this is one of the guys that I kind of don't like because he's made completely impotent by me using this ability on him. It's completely useless. Usually he's, you know, dashing across the stage to give you a thunder punch right in your face. He's real fast, hard to dodge. If you jump up and touch the ceiling where all the electric cables are, then you get hurt. You don't die instantly, but you do get hurt. You punch the ground, you have giant fucking lightning balls to try to kill you. But you hit him with the freeze shot, he's completely fucking worthless. Speaking of completely worthless, that's a nice raccoon on Armadillo. Every boss has giant fucking breasts. I don't know what's up with that. So, I'm gonna try to blitz through this stage as fast as possible. Which, if you do it right, you'll go pretty fucking fast. Here's a tip. If you're trying to figure out how to kill these guys, the giant fucking destroy everything in the face. Armadillo bulldozer things, whatever the fuck I guess you call them. That's your best bet. So fast kill them. Here's the one spot in the game where a fucking helmet comes in handy. You know, arguably. Damn it. I'm an idiot. I'm trying to collect all these health items so I can try to fill these E-tanks, because I don't want to. There is a part where you can refill your E-tanks, but it takes a lot of time. I don't want to waste it. I'll just throw it as a go. Fucking bats everywhere. I mean, you spend half the stage on these fucking, you know, just crazy mine carts. And as long as you jump at the right time with the momentum, then you save a whole lot of time. So the last guy was just guarding an E-tank. You didn't have to kill him if you didn't want to. But this guy you have to kill, because if you don't, then you can't reach the spot to jump up and get that. So, a little pro tip if you've never played this stage before. You could do it with other weapons, but I like that one as the fastest one. I'm trying to figure out what's fucking useless. By the way, up there, you see that little health item? That's where you get the Hadouken. You jump up there, you get the health item, and you fall to your death and repeat. You do that 5 times, and this is after you collect all of the other items in the game, by the way. You have to collect all the health tanks, you have to collect all the sub tanks, you have to get all the weapons, kill all the bosses, and then come back. And then once you do that, all the armor pieces as well. Once you do that, you go up there and collect the health item 5 times, and then Dr. Light will appear there with a fucking bandana on his head, and he'll give you the Hadouken. And while I was talking, I fucking destroyed this guy, because if you don't use the spark on him, he is the hardest boss in the game, because he takes way longer than all the other bosses, because he's invincible half the time, and does a fuck ton of damage with every shot. All those little beams do a crap ton of damage, and every one of those tackle attacks, if he hits you, does a crap ton of damage. So you're basically fucked if you don't have a spark on him. You hit him with a spark once, all his armor pops off, and he can't block anything after that. He's completely vulnerable. So I'm gonna fight Launch Octopus. Which, I hadn't really thought about it, but it recently came to my attention something that doesn't really make sense with the Mega Man universe. Is that, you know, there's a certain suspension of disbelief and sort of bastardization of, you know, physics and science with some video games. And in Mega Man, when you're, we all know that when you're in water, you can jump higher and all that good stuff. Like the buoyancy pushes you up and all these things, so you can jump way higher than you could in the air. Albeit slower. But that's not fucking true. Unless you're a Helium Man, which would probably be an awesome boss, by the way. I hate this guy, and I want to kill him as fast as possible, so I'm going to try that. And it seemed to work. But now, I'm about to run out of this fucking this attack that I deliberately waited to use on this boss, so I don't want to run out. Hopefully I can... Oh, damn it. There's another secret. Kill that thing. Do it with the hurricane attack because it does it in one shot. Fall down this pit that was just a giant pit of death. And then unveils a giant pit of more death, but with this guy. Okay, kill him first. Use the hurricane attack because once again, it's awesome. Kills everything in a couple of hits. And I heard him. He's dead. He's falling down. And then unlocks this level. Another health tank. So what is that? I got one more left. One more to find, and the final stage I haven't gone to yet. So I just gotta finish up this stage. Should be no problem. I'm not even halfway through the game yet. I'm about halfway through the game. It's going real fast. Which you think, you know, you look at everything, all things considered, the levels are way bigger than they are in Mega Man. And everything's cool. And you have to go back and recollect all the items that you may have missed. There's a lot more hidden stuff, you know. You don't just have to beat the level. You gotta go find shit. And maybe, you know, defeat hidden mini-bosses and stuff. But all things considered, this game is way faster than most of the Mega Man games. I beat this game with 100% faster than I beat some of the original Mega Man games. Just regular. It's kind of weird. But now, since I'm fucking around, I'm about to get myself fucking killed. Alright. It's either me or you. I think I'm gonna run out of weapon energy. But you see how I shot off his arms? God damn it. I'm an idiot. There you go. Take it like a man. One life sliver left. I persevered. I didn't give up. Didn't use the health tank or anything. One more boss to go. I don't know why there's air bubbles everywhere. He doesn't need to breathe. I don't know what's going on. Maybe he does. I don't know.